about 5:30 in the morning, and
I believe we'll have the sunglasses because it's going to be a bright sunrise.
Comes the firemen to the rescue. Oh, where's he going? This is ridiculous. Blocks out the sun. Look at the sun. Wow. That is freaking cool. There's Mr. Fireman. It's a discovery, and I'll probably have to find the guy who owns it, but somebody dropped the wallet. Not easy hitching a ride sometimes when you're out here in the middle of nowhere. It's a long way back unless you're running. I hear somebody right now. Crazy mileage. Let's do this out in the middle of freaking nowhere under this sign in the middle of the country. When you increase the mileage, just say, well, what? Here's a good rule. You do a 10% increase in mileage every third week in your train. Let's say you're building for 100 miles a week, or you've done 100 mile weeks before. That's about a 10 mile increase. So if you want to push 110, you do 3 weeks around 195 miles, and then you hit 110. Then you back off a little bit to about 110, 105. And you do that for about 3 weeks, 100 to 110 miles. Then you may want to go to 120 miles, right, after 3 weeks. And by the end of your 2 months base training season, you might have gotten an extra 20, 25 miles of per week training. And then you could cut back to that 100 miles a week again and start working on some more quality tempo runs, more race-specific stuff. So I'm going to end the video right there. Which help you guys run free, run awesome, never stop running, always inspiring. I don't know where the heck I am. I think I'm going to have to hitchhike home now. So peace out. I do that a lot here, by the way. Being out here. Just the wild berries, wild figs. Dates earlier in the season. A lot of wild fruit out here. That's a nice shot. Just gonna keep on going. It's pretty dark out. Alright, so figs. I see. Because there's no water up here.
They're dry?
They're very dry, yeah.
Yeah, they're still
it's too dry.
Too dry, too small.
Yeah. Here?
Yeah.
A thousand years ago. Looks like it was a house in here, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. I still gotta go all the way up there, 2,000 feet. Now that's a fire. Oh my god, that's a big campfire. Be in it, so.
I'll be in it.
There you go. Over here. Mm-hmm.
It's August 1st. I can't really see me. It's 1 p.m. Been having trouble breathing due to hypernatremia, lack of sodium. Gonna have to start supplementing with a little bit of sodium. So when it's over 100 degrees, you're running out in the sun all day. Best thing here is take is just Mediterranean sea salt. Put a little bit right there in your hand, just a little bit, and just swallow it and drink some water with it. Have some fruit with it, and that's your electrolytes. Simple, no chemicals, nothing artificial, no sports drinks, just pure sea salt. Has a lot of vitamins, magnesium, water from the ocean. I think it's the best thing for you. Put a little bit on your food at night.
It's 117 degrees today. No air conditioner inside. It's about 102 in my house, 98 degrees, and going for an afternoon run in a bit. All right, shit.
Whew, barely got out of this one alive. That's a fire.
All right, so the Achilles, I'm doing pretty good. Look, the scar's almost, it's really healed up and everything. But yeah, it's gone. All the pain. Been doing good. 120 mile weeks. And usually what my socks and shoes look like right now. Just really torn up. And just so dry being out in the heat. And just still good. Those were probably the best shoes I bought for a trail running. This is the New Balance XE900, I believe. Yeah. Over here, this is what you do with your fruit. When you got too much, you dry it out and you take it home for the winter. Boom. And I just could tell you, it's just incredibly hot right now. Probably about, still it's about 112, 110. About 3 in the afternoon, 4 in the afternoon. And you gotta water the plants, just digging holes. I'm just picking fruit. I come over here, and there's no fig tree figs, there's just so much now. And this had more plums on this tree. Probably had more plums than leaves on this tree, but these things were absolutely fucking amazing. Not as amazing as the figs, but, you know, there you go. Farm fresh. Going back pretty soon to New York. So, yeah, tomatoes. We got basil, garlic, rosemary, onion, bread, and a little bit of olive oil. Over here we got the pasta cooking, and we're put all together making an Italian dish. We got the caramel going, just in the middle. All right.
The first hill in the mountain, and we go up there where it's all burnt. Pino, whose place is this that's opening?
Piero. Piero.
Hey, buddy.
Taking a video.
Clear the water.
Hey.
Come on.
Bene.
Bene, bene. Tutto bene. Alisa.
I remember we are.
Self. Yeah.
Com'è? Santa Margherita di Belice.
Santa Margherita.
Santa Margherita di Belice.
Ah, sai che costa, no? Parisia.
Santa Margherita di Belice, provincia di Agrigento. Come siamo?
Provincia di Agrigento. Province of Agrigento.
Provincia di Agrigento. Mentre Castellammare è provincia Trapani, no?
Castellammare, sì.
Trapani.
Is the province of Trapani.
Trapani. Questo è Agrigento.
Paese vecchio.
Paese vecchio.
After the earthquake.
Sì.
Sì.
Terremoto.
Lo vedi che sul giallo?
Ok. Marina.
Ok.
Marina Samina.
A chi paese?
Yeah, cooler up here. Because when at sea level up at a certain altitude over here.
Sembra che ci sia stato un bombardamento.
Sì.
Earthquake. Wait,
hey Tony, it's a bottle of wine and a banana. It's a banana balloon.
Oh, this is a.
This is il frumento.
Porta frumento.
Esce di là. Lo metto di qua. Lo fa girare il trattore e lo butta nei terreni.
Il terreno è lungo fino a terreno.
My precious.